For as long as I can remember, I wanted to be a lawyer. My name is Linda Tucci Teodosio. I currently serve as judge in the Summit County Juvenile Court in Akron, Ohio. I always wanted to be a litigator, and I had the good fortune of going to work for three men who I greatly admire. It was a wonderful experience. I got a lot of courtroom experience. I got to argue numerous cases before the Ohio Supreme Court. Many of my colleagues really encouraged me that if the opportunity came, I should really consider running for judge. The one thing I discovered when I was in municipal court is I got the most satisfaction in working with the younger offenders. If you're working with a person who's 45 years old and on their 12th shoplifting charge, the chances of you really making a difference or an impact in their life are probably not that great. But with the younger offenders, you could see the hope and the fact that they could change the way they were doing things and really have an impact. So when some of my colleagues encouraged me to run for the juvenile court, it seemed like a perfect step for me. I'll tell you, it was the best thing I ever did. I really, really enjoy working with children and families. Well, wellness was really important to me when I ran for president of the State Bar Association. Little did I know back at that time that we would be in the midst of a pandemic by the time I took office as president. I think that just emphasizes the importance of wellness being at the top of the list for lawyers. When you think about it, a lawyer takes on not only their own issues and problems that they have in their personal life, which we all do, but also is taking on the problems and challenges of clients that come to them looking for solutions. And it can be a very stressful role to take on when you're taking on the weight of those problems and taking responsibility for them. And I'm really hoping in the coming year that the Wellness Advisory Committee that we are starting this year can work with some of our sister organizations to come up with some wellness tips for lawyers, especially in this time where many of us feel so isolated that we only see our colleagues on Zoom or in passing with a mask on. Events always shape what happens in a person's year as president. And while we couldn't have predicted COVID, we certainly couldn't have predicted that the killing of George Floyd would have sparked the numerous peaceful protests that we've seen across our state and across our nation. And I think that we need to be aware of that as lawyers. We also have a responsibility to protect the rule of law and make sure that it is applied equally. When you look at the protests, I think it becomes abundantly clear that a lot of our citizens do not feel that the law is equal and protects all of them. So we have started a process of creating a collaborative, trying to think about how we as an organization and we as a collaborative can work to restore the public's faith in our judicial system, faith in our system of government. And as the Bar Association, we're uniquely positioned to bring people together to make sure that we speak with a unified voice and provide guidance, education, information, and advocacy.